Hi, Danielson. You are one of the founders of the Optimal Citizen. So if you could just brief us about what this entrepreneurship is all about.
Yeah. Okay. So the Optimal Citizen is India's first purely positive newspaper in print and digital. So why we started this was very, very simple. We always woke up to newspapers which was filled with news about crime, corruption, scandal, what's going wrong with the world. And every day there was some news which was telling you why the world is bad. On the contrary, when we looked around, we figured out there are so many people who are doing good work, but they barely find a space in the newspaper. And that was a different narrative because the media was rather busy selling crime and fear to people. And we started realizing that over the period of time, all this negative news is conditioning the people to respond negatively to situations and circumstances, right? And imagine the soon-to-be youngest country of the world having most of its youth conditioned to believe that there is this problem and we can do nothing about it. And it's a dangerous situation to be in. So that's why we thought maybe we can, why not we have a positive newspaper which can inspire people to take positive actions. So the idea was pretty much simple. And entrepreneurship, you really don't, there's no set definition to it because it's pretty much like a habit. You are building an airplane on the fly. You don't know what to do when, but you just have to make do with what you have and figure out a way. So that's pretty much about entrepreneurship. There's no set definition. There's no set pattern to it because anybody who is taking that baton up is probably rewriting the syllabus all over again.
Alright, so the Optimal Citizen is a newspaper which is basically printed. Once a month it is printed and sold. So was this like your initial idea? Because like entrepreneurship is all about being creative and flexible. So that when you start, because it's an entirely new idea, when you start, on the way you need to make some changes so that your business venture keeps on going and does not just shut down. So was this like your initial idea, which is still going on? Or were there any changes that were made on the way?
All right. So, yes. So, yes, we had a lot of plans. It's like the problem with running a startup is that you remember those school days when you had 12 units for the examinations and you studied 10 and you thought, okay, I will pass with these 10 units and we'll figure out a way. And then the exam day, and you had questions mostly coming from those 2 years that you skipped. Startup and entrepreneurship is pretty much like that. You prepare for something and something else pops up and you're not prepared and you're like, okay, now what do we do? We just improvise. Yes, that happened. We wanted to start as a weekly and we realized printing is extremely expensive and more so is the distribution. It's a difficult business to run because print industry is a dying industry. One, second, distribution industry has a lot of logistical errors to it. And more than that, it's extremely, extremely expensive. So basically, what our printing cost is, our distribution cost is practically thrice the printing cost. So it was challenging. And we realized we cannot sustain it if we do it every month. We'll run out of money. So we made a conscious decision. Maybe what we can do is make it a fortnightly. And when we were making it a fortnightly, we also realized, okay, this is still a lot of expense for us to bear. And then we realized, okay, how do we make sure that these stories are read by everybody? Because if you keep giving them stories, 20 stories every week, probably they'll not read. And then we did an extensive survey with our readers on how frequently do you read? How much do you read? How much content do you want to have on a newspaper? How many pages do you want to have? How many colored, how many black and white, all of that. And after good number of interaction, good number of surveys, we got a fair idea. Okay, maybe people want to read, have a newspaper once a month, which has roughly 20 stories. Basically, 20 stories is easier to read for the entire period of month. And secondly, we can always give them one positive story on WhatsApp, because WhatsApp is still the most used social media platform, right, for communications. So every day we send a positive newspaper to our subscribers, and then we send a monthly newspaper. So that's how we revamped the entire model. And we have made plenty of blunders with respect to business plans. A lot of entrepreneurs usually shy away from saying this, but no, of course, if you're starting off new, you will definitely make blunders. But I think one should not be scared of taking those risks, because it's only in the initial phases that you can make all the mistakes, because it's better that you don't make them 10 years later, because that would be having more risks and more complications. So better learn early. So the only way to learn is make mistakes, try attempt something new.
Right. So as you told in the start that this was the first newspaper which had, like in India, which had all the positive news like in it. So how was it received initially? Like the first time you printed it, you published it, how was it first received by the consumers?
Mm-hmm. So the funny part is, when we were starting this, people had a lot of skepticism whether we will find stories enough to print a newspaper. People were wondering whether you will find positive stories. Milti kaha hai positive stories? This was the most common question that came to us. Kaha dhundoge khabar? But the first paper we printed was not a real newspaper. It was just a A3 size newspaper which we folded and had everyone wrote a news piece on a piece of paper and then pasted it on that A3 chart sheet, and had printed a few photographs from the internet and then pasted it. So just to make just to emulate how a newspaper would look like. And then when we went from place to place, we went to stationaries, libraries, we went to chart bhandars, asking people how they feel to have a newspaper in print with positive stories. And the best part of the entire process was that when we reached out to people, they were like, whoa, we didn't see this coming. And this is something great. We want to have this. And although they were more excited that a bunch of kids were doing this. And they were super excited. Okay, this is amazing. That was the biggest push we got, and perhaps we got the right push at the right time. We were just out of college. I was just out of college. We were still in the final year. So I was pretty much exploring what to do with my life next, and I'm glad it happened at the right time. Hey, so it's not a challenge.
All right. I'll just end it with the last question. So far, how much do you think this venture of yours has brought about a change in the society? So far, as you have noticed, I understand, and I think you've already mentioned about how last year was pretty much a horrific experience for the entire world to a large extent. And I'm pretty sure your venture has helped a lot of people to find out one ray of light in the darkest sky or cloud. So how would you summarize if you could to talk about how this venture has brought a change in the society in large or even in the smallest way?
There have been multiple recognitions that the organization has received. I'm sure you might have read about it. But yet, I think for us personally, the biggest achievement we have had is getting the readers to participate in positive actions. We have covered roughly 4,000 stories by now. So all those stories, when we put out to people, there is some reader at some part of the world who wants to reach out to this person and say, okay, I want to contribute or volunteer or donate to the mission that you're working on. I remember we doing one story about a guy from corporate who built a proto village in a barren land. This land had no food whatsoever for 17, 20 years. And then he worked with the villagers to build a 100% edible forest. So 100% edible is basically you pick up anything in the forest and you can eat it. So there was so much abundance after a few years that this village actually started enterprising and selling this food to other people. When we did the story, somebody from outside the country reached out to us saying this story was amazing. I'm an NRI. I have barely been to India in so many years, but I was so moved by the story. I have a piece of land. I want this man to replicate his model in my piece of land so that other people can benefit from that piece of land. And this is just one. And I probably have more than 1,000 of such stories. So the amount of commitment people give to good actions is probably the biggest reward we have had in these many years. With time, we have proved that people on social media are passionate about giving, about doing something, right? There's this bigger debate which says people on social media are a waste of time. Youth is wasting their time on social media. Instagram is useless. Snapchat is useless. We don't really believe it. I think if we give them the right opportunities, they can do the right thing. So one conviction that I personally have is that youth on social media is extremely passionate to do something. The onus is on us of what we give to them. If you ask them to click a selfie, they will do it with utmost passion, get the best filters, get the best lighting to it, right? If you give them some challenge of sorts, so maybe an ice bucket challenge or some kiki challenge, they will do all of it and make sure that it goes perfect, right? So they have energy to do something. All we need to do is channelize that energy into something more concrete, which is more purposeful. I have nothing against kiki challenge. I have nothing against selfie challenge. All of them are really fun. I don't participate in them because I'm rather camera awkward. It might not seem like so, but yes, I am. I feel awkward talking in front of a camera, but it's all good. But I think if we can find something more purposeful, why not? I mean, it's just a more garnishing to our life. So, yeah.
All right, great. Thank you so much for doing this and for actually taking an effort to do so much for a society. Thank you so much for doing this for us. Thank you.
Lovely talking to you, Lavisha.